And our beloved Prophet said, it's mentioned in the hadith of Sunan Abu Dawud, volume number 2 in the book of Zakat, hadith number 1631, that a rich person can receive Zakat under 5 categories. Number 1 is for jihad fi sabilillah. Number 2, if he is administrating the funds of Zakat. Number 3, if he gets into debt. Number 4, he can use Zakat money to buy something from a poor person who has received as Zakat. And number 5, that if his neighbor who was poor, who receives Zakat, and he uses that fund to give a meal to the neighbor who's rich. So even though it's Zakat, he can accept it. So these are the 5 categories mentioned. But in general, alhamdulillah, Zakat can be used for the propagation of Islam, alhamdulillah.
Okay. Dr. Zakir, what about in the case of a rich person who happens to be traveling and runs into problems, as it does happen when you're traveling? Is that person eligible to receive Zakat?
As far as the last category of Zakat is concerned, that's Ibn Sabil, that is a wayfarer or a traveler. If a person who's traveling, and if he gets stranded in a foreign land, even though he's rich, for example, a rich American comes and someone robs his suitcase and all his money and he's stranded. So Zakat money can be used for buying his ticket to go back home. He's a Ibn Sabil, he's a wayfarer. One option can be he can take loan and return the money back, but even he can take Zakat money. And this is a very good provision in Islam, because for example, a stranger in a strange land, who will know him? How can you trust him with loan? You know, the new person is there. You may not trust him. So if you can give Zakat, it is obligation. It's obligated due. So you can give it to a rich person also, and he can use, but it should only be used for going back. You can't use Zakat's fund so that he stays for long there and he uses the hotel and he has luxurious food, etc. It should be stated that he goes back to his place so that you help him out with the minimum requirement so that he reaches back safely home.
Dr. Zakir, what about the different categories of people who are not eligible to receive Zakat? Could you explain to the viewers who they are?
Amongst the categories who are not eligible, those who do not fall in the 8 categories mentioned in Surah Tawbah, chapter number 9, verse number 60, but natural, are not eligible to receive Zakat as a general rule. But there are some people who may fall in the 8 categories mentioned in Surah Tawbah, chapter 9, verse 60, yet they may not be eligible. First is the descendants of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 3, hadith number 2055, that once the Prophet sees a date falling down, and he said, I would love to eat it, but I'm afraid that it may be of charity, because the thing of charity cannot be consumed by the Prophet and his family. There's another hadith of Sahih Bukhari, volume number 2, in the book of Zakat, hadith number 1491, where Hasan ibn Ali, may Allah be pleased with him, once ate a date from what was part of the charity. So the Prophet said that expel it from your mouth, because the family of the Prophet, they cannot eat from what is given in charity. The reason is basically that people should not allege that the Prophet, you know, is taking Zakat. Zakat is compulsory of the Muslims and Prophet having from it. So it is the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he has seen to it that people should not lay an allegation. That's what I feel is one of the reasons. And the second category, those people who may fall in that category that are not eligible, is if he's a non-Muslim, if he's a non-believer. As Prophet Muhammad said, there's a hadith mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 2, in the book of Zakat, hadith number 1395, the Prophet said that it's compulsory to give Zakat on your wealth, on your property, and take wealth from the rich and give it to the poor. He told the Muslims. So it means that non-Muslims, but naturally excluded. Even the rich man is excluded. The rich man, you cannot fall in the category who cannot receive Zakat. And furthermore, the Prophet said, it's mentioned in the hadith of Tirmidhi, hadith number 661, the beloved Prophet Muhammad said that a person who is rich and able-bodied, he should not be given Zakat. That means a rich person who can really do some work and do a job, so but naturally should not be given Zakat unless he is doing a job and the salary he gets is not sufficient for his basic needs, then but naturally he may be able-bodied, yet you can give. But a normal person with able-bodied who's not doing a job and begging and asking for zakat, the Prophet never approved of it. And the last category is you cannot give zakat to a person who's a dependent. He may fall under 8 categories. He may be poor, he may be masakin, he may be needy, he may be in debt. But a person who's a dependent, like for example, a person cannot give zakat to his wife, for the wife is a dependent. A person cannot give zakat to his son or his daughter, because the children are dependent on the father. Similarly, a son cannot give zakat to his father and mother because they are the dependents. So this is the 5th category who zakat cannot be given, even though they may fall in the 8 categories of who have been permitted to receive zakat in Surah Tawbah, chapter 9, verse number 60.
Dr. Zakir, in the case of a person who wishes to give zakat to a non-dependent family member, what is the ruling on this?
As far as giving zakat to a family member who is not dependent, it is permissible. There's a hadith mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 2, in the book of zakat. Hadith number 1462. Once the Prophet Muhammad he was giving a khutbah after the Eid, whether it was Eid al-Fitr or Eid al-Adha. He was giving a khutbah and he told to the people that give alms, give charity, give zakat. Then he went to the woman and told them, give alms, give charity. And he comes back home. And then a lady by the name of Zainab, may Allah be pleased with her, she comes to the house of the Prophet and says, may I come in? So, who are you? So she says, I'm Zainab. Who's Zainab? Then Zainab, the wife of Ibn Masud, may Allah be pleased with him. Prophet said, yes, you can come in. So she says that because you told me to give zakat, I want to give my zakat and give the gold jewelry. But my husband, Ibn Masud, may Allah be pleased with him, he says that no one is more deserving than your husband and your son. So the Prophet replies, he is right. The most deserving of your zakat is your husband and your son, and giving to them the best people. So this proves that you can give zakat to your family member who is not a dependent. And further it's mentioned in the hadith of Tirmidhi, hadith number 2583, that giving charity to the poor is only charity, but giving charity to your near ones, it is also building relationships. So a man cannot give zakat to his wife because she is a dependent, but a wife can give zakat to the husband. Similarly, a son cannot give zakat to the mother, but a mother can give zakat to a son because a son is not dependent on the mother. It is the father who is responsible to take care of the family. Similarly, a sister can give zakat to the brother, but naturally, all of these relatives or non-dependent should fall in one of the 8 categories. Then they can give zakat to the relatives or non-dependent.
Well, Jazakallah khair for the answer, Dr. Zakir Naik, and indeed all of the answers you've given to all the questions, the numerous questions we've had on zakat tonight in our interview.